love the song. You and SZA, perfect partnership. Amazing. Tell us how that happened. When did you first meet? What was the vibe?
So I met SZA at an American Apparel 6 years ago.
Whoa.
I met her there, and then we were just like, hi, hi. And then I just like walked away, blah, 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 whatever. It was nothing. But then, but it was amazing to me.
Yeah.
I then made the song, and I made it in like the spirit of her. Like I just thought of her, and like it just felt right.
Yeah.
And I wanted to make a song about like kissing. Like I just thought it would be cute. Like that doesn't happen too often, but just like a song that's solely about kissing. So I started there, and then
SZA took it somewhere else.
She took it to like a deeper level, which is what I needed.
Who else did you work with on the song? Who helped put the whole structure and arrangement together?
My one friend, his name's Yeti, and he's been working with me for like the last 9 years. And yeah, he's incredible. I just kind of mumbled and did what I normally do every time, and that popped out.
Well, the subconscious approach to it is kind of what makes it sound natural. But then when it comes to kind of like filling in the gaps and actually giving it structure, is that what you do later on? You sort of go in there and you just let the words and the cadence flow, and then you're like, it sounds like this, sounds like this.
There's five ways to like approach it for me. But for this one, I was like, I did the melody first. And then I was like, I just started saying like, kiss me, or like, duh, 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 and it just made sense to do. I'm like, let me commit to like the topic of needing love, like needing to be kissed or needing like to be shown more like in a relationship. So I just was like, let me just talk about kissing, because that's like a good, there's a lot of things you can say about that.
Like many, many other people, I watched the Grammys with great interest. How are they going to figure this out? What are they going to do? I haven't had a chance to tell you this. I don't know if we'll go back to you. I thought your performance was off the chart fantastic. Like you were just so in the pocket.
Thank you.
I just wanted to applaud you for that, because a lot of times these award performances are like here today and gone tomorrow, and I wanted to just focus on that for a second, because to me it just looked like another level for you. Can we talk a little about the preparation of that performance, what you put into it, and how you felt about it on the night? Because I just felt like it set you on another bar altogether.
I feel like when you think of a Grammy performance, it's like 3 months of you know, rehearsal, and like it's a huge deal, blah blah blah, and like it is, but like we had 2 weeks to put this together. So we had the 2 weeks of rehearsal for like choreography, but I think the concept was definitely something that we had for like 2 months, 3 months. So like visually, like all that was kind of locked in by the time we started dancing. So I rehearsed for 2 weeks. And then, it was really, really difficult at first.
Even just jumping out of that box in those boots and landing it.
We tried different prototypes. I did the boots at the end, but we were trying to do heels. Heels were like, it was scary, but I really wanted to try. It looks so good. It's such a good silhouette.
How'd you feel at the end of it? Were you stoked?
Oh, no. So I performed. It was the first time that I've ever performed and then cried like a baby after. And I don't do that. I don't cry. I just get off stage and I'm like, yeah, we did it. Yeah. But for this, I like literally the director for the whole thing. Like he like came up to me and like, I was walking off stage and he was like, thank you so much. Like, you were amazing. And I'm like, thank you. And then we were rushing out and I like couldn't talk to him. And I was just like dying. And we were all crying. Everyone cried.
Was it crying or was it ugly crying? Is the difference?
Ugly, ugly. Everybody was like holding each other's shoulders and like looking at each other. Like, it was really, really corny. But it was the sweetest, like greatest, most intimate moment I've ever had.
I understand why. It's a huge amount of emotion, you know, and to me, it felt like a lot of the last kind of 12 months was boiling up to that moment of like, how do I show up here and how do I let the world see what I'm truly capable of? And it was really impressive. Like, I have to say, like, on just on a performance level, it was on a level with the greats I've seen in that environment. Those are not easy things to tame.
It was crazy. It was amazing. Like, so one fun fact about the helmets that the dancers were wearing is their ears actually lit up, like there was a glowing mechanism in the helmets. And so they had to learn to like do the spin in this crazy dance move and then click there's a little button. They have to click it all at the same time. We had to take that out.
How are you? How's life? I haven't spoken to you for ages.
I'm great. This morning I was suffering from cramps, but other than that, I've bounced back and I'm generally very happy. And yeah, I'm excited. I've been doing my makeup a lot, doing like interesting stuff on Instagram. So like that's brought me a lot of joy. And yeah, I'm excited to do more makeup stuff. I have some fun things coming soon.
I see your game.
Extremely excited about makeup these days. It's my new beacon of light.